Guys,
Amen.
Happy Sabbath. Are you guys excited to be here today? Come on, get excited. Get some excitement, some smiles. We're at church. I want to tell you guys a story today. How many of you guys like art? You like to draw? You like to color? We got Annie coloring a little book about cats back there. Some people like to really color. You guys like art? Very good. I want to tell you guys a story today about an artist. There was an artist, and he was a great painter, a great sculptor. He was great at anything that had to do with working with his hands. And he worked beautiful masterpieces. Can you guys make beautiful masterpieces? You're honest. I can't. Mine are bad. But he made awesome stuff. And they were in the houses of celebrities and the houses of rich people and royalty, kings, princes, all over the world, these beautiful paintings and sculptures that he made were there. And one day, this artist decided, that he was going to finally build himself a house. He had been living in just a small studio, he was working day and night, and he had all this money because he had been making these awesome things and selling them, and he said, "It's time for me to have somewhere nice to live." And so he called the carpenters, he called the people who built, they came, and he said, "I want this living room, and I want this dining room, and I want this size of a house." And they built him this beautiful house, and in the basement of the house, they made him a studio to work in. And you know what the potter did? He said, "I want to fill my house with awesome stuff." And so he went to Egypt and found beautiful linens and cottons. He went around the world and found beautiful rugs and the comfiest furniture. And he filled his house with all this awesome stuff. But there was one room in his house where he could not find something to put in there. And it was the entryway. We have an entryway here at the church. It's where everyone comes in to see. It's the first room people see. It's the first impression. And so finally, after searching and searching and searching, he decided, "I'm just going to create my own thing. I'm going to put something in there. I'm going to make something, a sculpture to put into the entryway of my house." You guys have anything in the entryway of your houses? When you open the front door, is there anything in there? At Amy's house, there's a cat. Yeah, she's not my idea of a beautiful sculpture. But he wanted something amazing. So he went down into his basement, and for 2 days straight, he built this amazing sculpture. And he was so proud of this sculpture that he put it on a table in the middle of his entryway, and he invited all of his friends over to see this amazing thing he had created. Everyone came, and they thought it was beautiful. They thought it was amazing. And as everyone left that night, as the potter was getting ready to go to bed, something terrible happened. He heard his door break open, and he heard a shatter. Have you guys ever broken anything that's your parents? Yeah, it's kind of scary when that happens. Something shattered, and so the potter ran downstairs to the entryway of his home, and as he ran down, he saw a robber, a thief, running away in his front yard, and on the ground was his beautiful sculpture that he had made, broken into a million pieces. The potter was devastated. He was so sad. But you know what he did? After stopping and looking at his broken creation, he sweeped it all up, he put it on a table, and day by day he glued each and every single piece back together. And you know what he did when he put it all back together? He brought it back into the entryway. He set it right there on a pedestal for everyone to see. And he put a light inside of it. And when he stopped and looked, he saw that it was even more beautiful than it was before, because light was shining through each and every crack. I wanted to tell you this story today for a simple reason. The potter represents Jesus. You know Jesus created you? Jesus made you. But a robber came, Satan. And he brought sin into this world. He brought heartache and pain, and he broke us. But instead of just throwing us out in the garbage, just sweeping us away and starting over, God took us back into his workshop. He put us back together. And now, today, his light shines through all our weaknesses, all of our imperfections, and all of our flaws. And we're even more beautiful than we were because of him. And so today, I want to encourage you guys to accept Jesus. As you get older, as you grow up, you're going to notice things about yourself. Let him shine through those things. Will one of you guys pray? I'm going to choose one of you.
Let's pray. Jesus, thank you for what you did. Take care of us. And help us to be obedient, be pure, be true, be kind, be respectful, be attentive, be helpful. Be cheerful, be kind, and be respectful. In Jesus' name, amen.
Amen.